All right, you guys. So today is May the 31st. It is 8:50 a.m. and I am at my pre-op appointment. I'm super duper excited. My appointment surgery date is scheduled for June the 10th, which is next week Friday. And I'm just ready to get this over with. Yeah, I am. I'm stupid excited though. Like, I'm really, really excited. I'm not nervous. I'm just excited. It's something that I've been wanting.
Hey y'all, so I made it home from surgery. I'm just going to chill out for the rest of the day. My pain level is probably at like a 3. I just have a lot of pressure. That's it. Not really in any pain, just pressure. Especially up at the top. But that's it. I'm about to probably knock out. And then I'll do a quick update. Alright, so it's still after the surgery day one. It is 11:45, I think, almost 12 o'clock. Just wanted to get on here to do a quick update. So I really didn't get to vlog like me when I woke up and stuff, because I still had so much stuff I had to do this morning before the surgery. And so I really didn't get into detail of everything. But it's 11:45, like I said, June 10th. I'm really not in that much pain. Just shortness of breath because of the pressure. And it's so tight. But other than that, everything is going good. I have not seen them yet. So I get to take a shower tomorrow. So once I take my shower, I get to see what they look like. But so far, they are, they're pretty good. I think they're a pretty good size. I think my doctor definitely did what needed to be done. So we shall see how day 2 post-op goes. See y'all tomorrow. All right, y'all. Good morning. It is post-op day number 2 for me. I am feeling good. Still a little drowsy. That's the only problem that I have because I'm taking medications. But I slept okay. Pain level is still at like a 2 or 3. I'm not in any pain. Just the tightness and the stiffness. That's the only thing. But and today they are sitting up pretty high. This right one is a little swollen, and that may be because the right one has more CCs. So I got my ice packs. About to put ice. I iced all day yesterday, and that's really it. But my shoulders are like extremely, extremely exhausted. My arms really didn't hurt that much either. I know when I was looking at other people's YouTubes, they were complaining about their arms and everything like that. So I'm just grateful that I'm not in extreme pain. That was one of my main concerns. Shouts out to my doctor, Dr. Colgrove, the best. I had an amazing experience yesterday. Everybody made me feel comfortable, everything. So it was amazing, truly, truly amazing. I'm gonna try to eat some solid foods. I started out with like soups and stuff yesterday, only because I really wasn't in the mood to like pick up food, trying to eat. So I'm gonna do that. My husband was so amazing yesterday. I literally didn't have to do anything. He kept asking me, do I need anything? Checking on me, adjusting me, anything I needed. Love, love, love him. But he had to go to work today. So now I'm just waiting on my parents to come, and I will keep you guys updated. Bye. All right, y'all. I'm back. Still day two. It's just a little later during the day. I think it's like 3:45-ish. So I'm back. My parents came to visit me. And my mom came to help me with a shower. And I feel so much better. So much better. That first shower is everything. Pain level still probably at like a 2. Haven't really felt that much pain. I have been sticking to my medicine plan. And I told myself that. I'm not trying to be like nobody else. Like, oh, I don't need the pain meds, this and that. Whatever they told me to take, I'm taking it. And it's been helping so far. But I can't tell when it's starting to wear off, because that's when a little pain starts coming. But other than that, I'm fine. Still sort of in and out of it because of the medicine. I don't know what this is on my lip. But yeah, so far so good. I finally got to see my boobs without the wrap and surgical bra on. And I am very, very pleased with my results. Very, very, very pleased. Very happy. But other than that, that's it. I will see you all later. One more time. Hey y'all, it is post-op day 3. It is about 11:30 in the morning now. I woke up very, very stiff. My chest has so much pressure on it. And every time when I wake up, that's when, you know, the stiffness starts to set in or whatever. So still feeling a lot of pressure. Not too much pain, just pressure. So that's where we are. I can probably say day 3 has been the worst for me, especially with the getting up. I didn't have to really deal with this on day 1 or 2. So yes, but I'm still thankful, still grateful that I'm not in any pain. All right, y'all, so it's still post-op day 3. I am looking about crazy. My husband said I need to get out the house and do something. So, I'm trying. But today, my left boob is killing me. The muscle spasms is ridiculous. So, I'm trying. I'm feeling a lot better. So, we'll see. All right, y'all. So, I'm finally up, not sitting down. I know every time I get on here, I'm like laying down, but I'm up. It is post-op day number 4. I'm on my way to the doctor for my appointment. I'm about to try to shower by myself. I'm home alone for the first time ever. So I'm about to try to shower. The girls are like really doing good today. Just a little bit of pressure, not a lot. Hold on. And they are looking gorgeous. So, still a little tight up here. And I know I've been watching like a lot of YouTube saying about the fluid and stuff. So, I'm definitely feeling the fluid like around this area, which means that they're trying to settle into the pocket. But so far, so good. I'm feeling good today. I'm gonna try to get my energy back up and going and not take any pain pills, because that's what really gets me. The muscle relaxer and the pain pills makes me so drowsy. But yesterday, day 3 was like my worst day. It was really, really bad yesterday. The pain and the pressure was like, I could not tolerate it. And it was worse than like day 1, I was fine. Day 2, I was fine. I think day 3 was just because everything was, you know, there, and it was like, okay, I think this is my spot. But my muscle spasms was like going in, okay? So I'll update you guys, let you guys know how my post-op go, and hopefully they say I can change into a different bra, because this compression bra, oh my goodness, it's killing me. So hopefully I get some good news out of that soon. All right, see y'all later. Bye.
All right, y'all. So I'm back from my post-op appointment. Everything went good. They just checked my incisions, making sure I'm healing okay. Changed my tape out from where my incisions are because I have to keep that clean. So like when I shower, I have to make sure it's covered and everything. It's a whole process. But so far, I don't have too much swelling on this side, but this side is still swollen and really sitting high up. And like if I press on it, I can feel the fluid, but I know it's normal. But yeah, this has been a process, a whole struggle though, but definitely worth it, okay? Definitely worth it. For me to have some girls, okay? Definitely, this one is still sitting high up in my chest, but it's gonna drop a little like this one is. So far they're looking really good, but still a little swollen. So I'm probably gonna put some ice on it today. Ice, and highly recommend CBD cream. This has been helping me out a lot for my recovery. Cause your muscles are, all of this is so sore. Under my arms, sore. Like I can't even put on my own deodorant. I have to get my husband or my mom or somebody to put it on. Really, really sore. This cream does wonders. Please get you some. If you are thinking about getting a boobie augmentation, get you some CBD cream, please. And I got this off Amazon, but please, I highly recommend it.
Also, I wanted to show y'all how I have myself set up, because you know, you have to sleep sitting upright like for the first 2 weeks. And when I was like looking on YouTube and stuff, I noticed that most of the women that were in pain was because they were getting in the bed and they were trying to sleep straight up in the bed. So luckily I have recliner chairs, and I know somebody else on YouTube highly recommended, like if you have a recliner, just lay in a recliner. So that's what I did. So I ordered me one of these back pillows. And then I also have, you know, the neck pillows from the airport, which works wonders. And also, I know a lot of people don't have this, but I have a heated back massager, and it helps me so, so much. But I just recline the chair all the way back, and that's how I've been sleeping. And then I use this pillow to kind of prop my legs up. And so far, it's been working wonders, okay? So this is my little spot.
All right, y'all, so it is post-op day 5. And I know I'm looking a hot mess, but your girl has been going through it, okay? So I know yesterday I did a little recording for day 4, and I did record some footage for day 3, and I must say that day 3 and day 4 is the worst ever. It was bad. So last night I wanted to get in my bed, because sleeping on this recliner, oh my goodness, it hurts my back so much. And yesterday I was just over it, like I'm in the chair nonstop. So I thought it'd be a bright idea to get in the bed, just being lazy, acting like a princess, missing my bed, okay? So I tried getting in the bed, and I was in the bed for a while. My husband kept telling me that it wasn't a good idea, that I should still sleep on the recliner. And I insisted on getting in the bed. So I got in the bed. I fell asleep in the bed for like a couple of hours. And I woke up to my husband literally like picking me up. He said I had slid, like I was sliding down. You know, you have to sleep sitting up. So once he had to literally pick me up, like scoop me up, and make sure I was straight, like on the headboard. So after he did that, I ended up falling back to sleep. Once I fell back to sleep, I woke up, it was like 3 a.m, and I could already feel it all up here. Like the pressure was unbearable at the point, like I was in tears. And I had to get up and go to the restroom, and I didn't want to wake my husband up because he has to be to work in the morning. So I forced myself, it took all of my energy, but I forced myself to like kind of turn with my bottom half and make sure both my feet was on the ground.
and I kind of had to sit up, like, you know, rock a little bit to sit up at an angle. And once I did that, I felt so much better. But my chest was throbbing. I think last night everything was kind of getting settled in, and I probably woke up at the wrong time. So when I got up, I went to the bathroom, and I was like, absolutely not. I cannot get back in this bed. And so my husband got all my stuff, and we came right back downstairs, and I felt so bad. But shouts out to him, because he has been doing everything for me, literally. If you're thinking about getting a breast augmentation, please, please, please make sure you have somebody there to help you. I know, like, at my doctor's office, they said make sure somebody stays with you the first night. No, they need to be with you the first week, because you don't know what's going to happen and how your body's going to heal. And my body is... He just fell because he was trying to jump over the sofa. My body is, I want to say it's healing pretty good, but it's just this whole process that... It's just this whole process that, you know, I'm getting used to, especially the tightness. It's so tight, y'all. Especially if you ain't had no boobs like I did. Ooh! And then you trying to put some implants in. Ooh! It's pressure. It's horrible, okay? So just make sure that you're ready for that. I know this shirt is dirty, but what's up, y'all? So today is post-op day number 5, I think. It is Wednesday. I got my surgery last week, Friday. And, today is like the first day I got up, put some clothes on, tried to do something to my hair. I thought I was really doing something. You know, this was the first day that I got up and I just literally felt sore. Like I'm sore. Like, it feels like I'm sore. It's not pain. Still pressure is there, but it just feels like I'm real tight. Like somebody has my chest, like, stretching it. Like, right in the middle. That's it. So, I went to the mall. I went to go get my oil changed today. Went to go get my nails done. Because, you know, they had your girl out here all the way naked for surgery. I mean, naked. I couldn't have on no nails, no polish, no nothing. So, I did all of that today. So that's where I've been. But I've made it back home. I'm about to try and shower. My showers seem to take me all day now. So, I'm going to get a head start before my hubby gets home. I'm going to go ahead and take my shower. Get dressed. Put some, you know, chill clothes on. And then I'm going to try to do a vlog, like, just to kind of sum everything up. From like my consultation these last couple of days, and yeah, and that should be it. And then I'll probably do like a 3-week update, and I'm excited about that. But today is like really the, like, one of the days where I woke up and I felt really normal. So I was like, oh, okay, I think, you know, my body is getting used to my implants, or my implants are getting used to my body. Whichever one, somebody's getting used to something, because I really, really felt really good. So I'm gonna come back on here and do some more videos. See y'all soon. All right, y'all. So today is post-op day 6. I am almost at my week mark. Tomorrow will be a whole week since I got my breast off. And so far, so good. It's been a long journey. It's been a long week. I can't even believe, like, it's been a whole week. I can't believe it. It went by so fast. But it's been a whole week. 6 days, I went to another post-op appointment. So every 3 days, I have to go and get my tape changed under my incision. They clean it and change it for me, whatever. So I went and did that today. Monday, I'm going to change it myself. Wednesday, I'm gonna go back, hopefully see my doctor, because I haven't seen him since before surgery. I've just been checking in with the nurses. So hopefully Wednesday I'll see him and he'll let me know further steps and what else I need to do. But yeah, it has been definitely a journey. A struggle, Duggle. It really has. Monday and Tuesday were like my worst days ever. Definitely not fun. Monday night was, oh my goodness, I was struggling so bad, y'all. So bad. So happy it's over. So happy I did it. Definitely worth it. My girls are looking amazing. It's so crazy how your body adjusts to new things, I guess. Because I'm starting to see them transform. Like, I've been taking pictures. Of course, I've been taking pictures, like, every single day. From the beginning, like, day one, day two, day three. Because I wanted to see, you know, the breasts dropping. And it's so crazy how, like, your body just can, I don't know, like, work its way out into adjusting to new things. I guess if that makes any sense. But yeah, so each and every day they're looking better and better, because at first, baby, let me just tell y'all, when I took my first shower, me and my mama was in that bathroom, I was like, I know you lying. I know this ain't the surgery, but you have to give it time. So to all my women out there thinking about getting their boobies done, your boobs have to adjust to the implant. They have to adjust, okay? And it takes time. And it's a part of the healing process. So just remember that. Tell me what you want.